A few things that were coming in earlier, you did some breath work today. We talked about breath work and the benefits of that. Are there any contraindications that we might need to be aware of with breath work, or maybe suggesting that or walking our clients through something like that?
Yes, specifically with clients who maybe have higher anxiety traits or any past trauma with even like claustrophobia or anything like that, specifically with the alternation or the manipulation of closing and opening mm-hmm. the nostrils, sometimes that might feel like you're not able to fully catch your breath. Mm-hmm. So just being mindful that those populations might just want some calmer, slower rhythm types of breath. One of the studies that I looked at really looked at that the slower the rhythm of the breath and just really connecting the exhales with the inhales was more beneficial. Mm-hmm. Other types of breath work that I didn't mention today or didn't talk about today for those reasons of contraindications is sometimes some breath work practices or breath work workshops that I've been to focus on really heavy and fast styles right. of breathing
right.
where that can bring up some either negative emotions or just negative physical responses, mm-hmm. specifically mm-hmm. with our populations that can have any types of panic or attacks or induce those. So definitely something to be mindful of. Mm-hmm. And again, that connection with your client of asking them, do you have any past history, and just making sure if that's something that you're going to share with your client, just making sure that we're checking with that first.
Right. Yeah, definitely. And you're mentioning mindfulness quite a bit, right? And part of yoga is mindfulness. And would we even say that before suggesting a typical breathing technique, that just maybe suggesting a client become mindful of their breath is a
yes.
part of what we could offer them?
Yes. So even bringing awareness, right, to the rate of your breathing. Mm-hmm. Is your breath feeling shallow? Is your breath maybe a little bit more fast paced if you're just running around and just got to your session? Mm-hmm. And just bringing awareness, right? So mindfulness is bringing awareness to the present moment with that intention, and then adding any type of mindful breathing. And that's something that a lot of the yoga practices that I've studied or looked at and practiced today really first set the foundation with: where is your breathing today? And these are all just options, right? So even in my classes, I'll give the offering of you can practice with Ujjayi breath, but really just find a breath that works for you mm-hmm. today. Mm-hmm. If that's breathing in and out through your mouth, because it can sometimes feel like a lot of work to
right.
think about that too.
Right. If somebody's stuffy.
Yeah, definitely.